My name is Bob Hughes from National Institute for School Leadership. In an earlier part of my life, I was Dean of Faculty and Academic Programs at National War College here in Washington, D.C. So what's the connection between the National War College and NISL? Well, here it is, and here's the story that I'm going to tell you in connection with the Cuban Missile Crisis. When the National Center on Education and Economy first received its remit from the Carnegie Corporation of New York to look into senior leadership, executive leadership in the world of public education, they were also asked to compare and contrast that work and those successes with what was going on in the training of senior executives within the business world, within the world of the military, engineering, law, and medicine. And so they came to me at one point because I had been the dean at National War College, and I worked with the investigators plus a couple of retired deans, and we looked deeply into what was going on in American public education in terms of professional development and the preparation of senior executives. It was part of that story that led to my joining NISL in July of 2001. Shortly thereafter, we began to put the curriculum together for the program that turned out to be the executive development program some 2.5 years later. And in that program, we wanted to use case studies. Well, we didn't want to just use case studies out of the world of education. We wanted to draw as much as possible out of the world of business, political military affairs, and even medicine if we could find the right case. And so we had transformation at Ford. And in the early unit, we have Singapore, which is international education, and of course, we also have the Cuban Missile Crisis. Now, why the Cuban Missile Crisis? Well, the Cuban Missile Crisis is a story about potentially the most catastrophic event in the history of mankind. Let me repeat that, potentially the most catastrophic event in the history of mankind. You may not remember or realize that there was the potential loss of 200 million casualties, deaths, in the Soviet Union and in the United States if that disaster had actually occurred. Extremely, extremely to the edge, I would say this is truly existential. This was a matter of survival in the extreme. So that's one reason we would pick the Cuban Missile Crisis. Because here a young president brought all of the decision-making apparatus of the United States from the contextual analysis to a vision of where we would end up to the strategies that would get us there to the decisions and actions. And oh, by the way, that's exactly the conceptual framework that NISL offers its participants in strategic thinking. The context, the vision, the strategy, the milestones of decisions and actions. So that's why we're at the Cuban Missile Crisis. And it isn't that we expect any of you and hope that none of you come anywhere near any even disasters of a minor order that you have to deal with. However, the main steps are there. However, the degree of seriousness of whatever the crisis is that you're facing and whatever the decision-making model is that you have to work your way through. So we are using the Cuban Missile Crisis for lots of good, strong reasons. Another piece of this is that we chose it because it's full of ambiguity. It is full of intrigue, as a matter of fact. Who are these players? What do they know? What do they not know? What's the intended consequences? What are the unintended consequences? Is there fog? Is there friction? Are there pieces that we don't know about, that we should know about if we're going to make clean decisions? So for all of those reasons, we have chosen the Cuban Missile Crisis from 1962. We're going to talk primarily about the period 16 October through 28 October 1962, but I'm going to broaden that out very, very much, and you'll see that all crises really have beginning, middles, and ends that extend beyond even what you're immediately dealing with. I want you also to understand that this is not just a mental exercise. This is not an exercise in conceptualization or history, or even the uses of history, as Neustadt may want you to take the case, but rather this is for the application that you see to the world of education. I want you to take the case to the extent that you can and see similarities and differences with the way that you go about making decisions. Again, not to the limit situation that we're dealing with in Cuban Missile Crisis, but even to the minor crises that you go through as a manager and leader. So with that as background, let's go ahead.